हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? दिस इज प्रमिला मलिक, पीजीटी इंग्लिश. एंड टुडे वी विल डू पोएम द लेबर्नम टॉप, रिटन बाय टेड ह्यूज फॉर 11th इंग्लिश फ्रॉम हॉर्नबिल बुक. एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल गिव द शॉर्ट इंट्रोडक्शन, वर्ड मीनिंग्स, लाइन बाय लाइन एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द पोएम. The poem Laburnum Top by Ted Hughes describes the mutual relation between a laburnum tree and a goldfinch. Both of them are yellow in color and quite beautiful in appearance. The tree is yellow because of its flowers. The laburnum tree is beautiful, large, but quite silent. However, the bird goldfinch appears from the sky. And soon the tree is surrounded by the sweet chirrups of the bird and her young ones. It was previously dead and now it seems to be alive and shaking until the bird vanishes away again. Dead silence prevails. The poem has been divided into three stanzas. There is no set rhyme scheme. The first stanza describes the tree before the bird reaches it. The second stanza describes the coming of the bird. And the final stanza tells the condition of the tree when the bird goes away. So, let us read the poem first. The laburnum top is silent, quite still, in the afternoon yellow, September sunlight, a few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen, till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup, a suddenness, a startlement at a branch end, then sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt, she enters the thickness and a machine starts up of chitterings and a tremor of wings and trillings. The whole tree trembles and thrills. It is the engine of her family. She stokes it full, then flirts out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. Then, with eerie delicate whistle chirrup whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite and the laburnum subsides to empty. See the word meanings first. Laburnum. Laburnum here means a small tree with hanging branches of yellow flowers and poisonous seeds. Top. Laburnum top means the top of the laburnum tree. Silent means mute. Quiet means fully. Still means stable. See the explanation of this first stanza. You can easily see that in the very first stanza, we have only three lines where the poet is saying that he saw a laburnum tree with its yellow flowers. In his words, the laburnum top is silent. The tree is still and looks dead-like in the daytime of September. Even the sunlight is also yellow. Yellow sunlight. The laburnum top is silent, quite still. It means no movement is there. In the afternoon, which month's afternoon? He is talking about September month. And yellow, the word yellow is used for both the leaves of laburnum tree and for sunlight also. So, as it is the time of autumn, the leaves of the tree have turned yellow and its seeds have fallen off it. How we can know that autumn season is there? Because the seeds of the laburnum tree have already fallen. In this stanza, the poet uses the image yellow color repeatedly. First, the tree's flowers are yellow, then its leaves. Flowers are yellow, then leaves have also turned yellow, and the sunlight is also yellow. The yellow color symbolizes beauty, Why? Because of flowers, which do even have fallen off in the form of seeds. Then it symbolizes death. Why? Because of yellow leaves. And again, the yellow color symbolizes silence. Why? As the daytime without rain or wind. So in the whole stanza, this first stanza, the poet is trying to describe the miserable condition of the laburnum tree, which is silent, dying, and without seeds, useless. Now come on to the next second stanza. First of all, see the word meanings. Goldfinch means a small singing bird with yellow feathers on wings. Twitch means movement of a small body part. Chirrup, you already know, sound made by birds. Suddenness means suddenly. Startlement, amazement, a sudden unexpected action which causes surprise. Sleep means smooth. Alert means active. Abrupt means sudden or unexpected. Chitterings, singing sound of a bird. Tremor, shiver, shake. Trillings, singing repeatedly. Stokes means add fuel to the engine. Then flirts, moves briskly, moves quickly. Barred means strippy. Then eerie means strange. Infinite means, here refers for the sky, infinite sky. Subsides means returns, lessen or cease. Now understand the meaning of this second stanza. The death-like scene, however, changes as soon as the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup. Goldfinch is a bright yellow-colored bird. Twitching chirrup means short chirrup sounds. The bird is quite precautious while sitting at a branch end of the tree and has sudden quick movements. Perhaps it is looking out for any danger that might be there. It then goes into the thick bark of the laburnum. Laburnum here refers for the tree. Smoothly but abruptly. Abruptly means suddenly. With alertness. As soon as she enters the tree, a machine starts up of chitterings and a tremor of wings and trillings. Her nest is inside the laburnum tree. The image of machine here refers to the young ones of the bird. A machine makes a lot of noise when it starts. Similarly, when the young birds see their mother, they start chirping like a machine, fluttering their wings fastly in joy as their mother has come with food. They were hungry as well as sad being far from their mother. Now the whole tree trembles and thrills because of the mother bird and her young ones. The poet probably wants us to feel how a dead-like tree becomes alive because it has given space to the bird and her young ones. The birds have gotten shelter and the tree in return has got life. The goldfinch is thus the engine of her family. It is written, it is the engine of her family, which includes the laburnum tree as well. According to the poet, it fills them with fuel. She stokes it full. Stokes means add fuel to the engine. So, it fills them with fuel. It gives food to the young ones and thrills to the tree. Having done this, she again flies to a branch end. Only her dark colored striped face, her barred face means her dark colored striped face is visible as it is yellow. and hence becomes invisible in the yellow leaves of the tree. Then, with eerie, delicate whistle chirr of whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite, and the laburnum subsides to empty. Word meanings we have already discussed. Eerie means strange, queer, and launches means started, subsides means lesson, returns, cease. Reaching the branch end of the tree, it makes strange but sweet cheer of sounds and then begins his journey towards the infinite. Infinite here refers for the sky. And the laburnum tree again becomes silent and dead-like. So, students, this is the whole explanation, entire explanation of this poem. I hope you understood it well. Here again I am presenting the summary of this poem one more time. Listen it carefully. The poem begins with the description of the laburnum top. On a September afternoon, the top of the tree stands silent and still. The leaves of the tree have started yellow and the seeds have already fallen. The scene depicts the season of autumn. And how we can know? Because the seeds of the laburnum tree have already fallen. Then in the second stanza, the sudden arrival broke the silence of the tree. The bird arrives at the end of the branch with a chirrup. Then she abruptly, quickly, suddenly enters the thickness of the branches, just like a lizard. So comparison is being made by the poet. As she arrives, it seems as if a machine has started. Why? As the young ones of the goldfinch are filled with excitement and start creating noise on the arrival of their mother. They start chirping and fluttering their wings. With their chirrups and movements, the whole tree comes alive and it trembles and thrills. Thus, it becomes the engine of her family. She feeds the young ones and after feeding them, she comes to a branch and showing her buried face. To whom? To the small ones. Finally, with a whistle chirrup, she flies towards the vast sky, leaving the tree once again calm and quiet. So, this is the explanation. And now let us discuss some of the literary devices which are used in this poem. Number one and the most commonly used literary device which is used in this poem is alliteration. Alliteration, you know, where we use alliteration. Or what is the meaning of alliteration? Repetition of consonant sound at the beginning of two or more consecutive words. Likewise here, September sunlight. Tree trembles. So, tree trembles here. Tree trembles. T sound is used. S sound is used. So, because of S and because of T sound, alliteration is used. Now, the next one is simile. See, second stanza's third line. Then sleek as a lizard. So, comparison is used here. When we use direct comparison by the use of like and as words, we say that simile is there. So, as a lizard. Direct comparison is here. Simile. Next one is metaphor. Where we use indirect comparison. Generally, quality is compared. She enters the thickness. She means goldfinch. When the goldfinch enters the thickness and machine starts up, here the noise created by the movement of the bird is compared to the machine's engine. So, there metaphor is used. Then, we see personification. You know personification, where inanimate objects are given human traits. So the whole tree, laburnum tree, is full of personified. Here the tree is personified. Trembles, thrills, these are the words which are used to personify laburnum tree. Then one more literary device is used here, that is transfer epithet. Transfer epithet is used where the adverb is transferred to another noun. Here, her barred face. It becomes that the bird's face becomes her identity and a symbol of recognition. So here, which literary device is used? Transfer epithet. So this is all about this poem. I tried my best to explain you everything, describe everything, and I hope that you understood all the content of this poem. Word meanings, explanation, line by line explanation, along with literary devices. So students, if you like this video, please subscribe, like and share my channel, Study with Pramila Malik. Thank you so much for watching my video.